Hello, this is R-I-C-K-Y, the YouTube Tech Guy. Hey guys, so today I'm bringing you the video on how to dramatically improve the camera on the Galaxy S24 series. Now, I'm gonna be using the S24 Ultra, but you can use a lot of these same features on the S24 and S24 Plus. So with this phone, you can really do so much more than how it comes out of the box. Out of the box, it's okay photos, but once you do these steps, you're gonna see dramatically better photos. Now, I won't be going over how to improve the overall phone. That is in a separate video on how to get 5 hours more battery life and all the good features there. But with this one, let's go ahead and get started on this camera. All right, now for the first feature, it is just always something that not a lot of people know about unless you've had a Samsung phone before, but you can always double press the power button to quickly launch the camera, and that'll launch from any screen whatsoever. Simple, perfect, and easy to be able to do. So right away, I want to get into the first thing, and it will pop up when you get really close. So when you're further away, it won't show, but when you get really close, you're gonna have these two little dots over here. And what this will do is it'll implement Samsung's really not good feature of focus on. So you turn that off and it keeps it at the highest resolution camera, which is a lot better than this ultra wide shot, which is nowhere near as good. So this is called a macro shot. Basically, the idea behind it was that Samsung was like, oh, well, we'll make a better focus and all this kind of stuff. It doesn't work. A lot of other brands do it too. Don't get me wrong, Pixel, Apple, none of it ever works. So turn that off and it'll give you a much better shot. That's first and foremost. Second, we're gonna show you how to take overall better photos, but this requires an app that Samsung doesn't necessarily let you know about. So I'm gonna go to it right now, and that is in the settings section. We're going to make sure and see if you have camera assistant here. If you don't, let me show you how to get it, because this will dramatically improve the focus and quality of your photos. All right, so if you do not have camera assistant on your phone, you can get it from the Galaxy Store, and that is this one. So this one that looks like this is the Galaxy Store. It should come with your phone. So you're going to open that and search for camera assistant, right? And again, it will look like this. So this is the one you're looking for. However, some phones, I will tell you, I've already seen, do not even have this available just by searching on the store. And you have to download this app, which is the overarching app that improves your overall Samsung phone that we went over in the other video, and that is Good Lock. So what we're gonna do is open up the Galaxy Store and find Good Lock, and just gonna type that in. And there it is at the top. And once you open this app, you have a lot of different features that come with it. Again, I go over these in other videos, but the one you're looking for right now is the Camera Assistant. So go to Life Up, Camera Assistant, and this is the one where I'll be going over how to improve your photo quality right away. Now, there are a lot of fun things you can do with this that will change your overall camera. So first off, I'm gonna go for zoom shortcuts. If you do wanna hit 2X as well, this will make it so that when you pull up your camera, 2X is now available instead of just 3, 5, and 10. You can also just go straight to 2. Some people like this crop a little bit better, so this is available shortcut at the top instead of always having to wait to tap one, and then you can see the other numbers. So hopefully that'll help you out if you want a little slight cropping. And then we get to the next part, which is high resolution settings. You want to make sure both of these two are on. So this is going to allow you to have adaptive pixel, basically switch to the correct low light and make it a higher resolution, including when doing upscale digital zoom. Not sure why this one is off by default, but it definitely is gonna be better. It will take more processing power, but again, you're gonna have much better quality photos, so I think everyone will be happy with that. Now, this is the number one thing to do in this setting portion, and that is prioritize focus over speed. Now, it's not too much of a difference in terms of the movement, in terms of how long it takes the shutter to last. I'm still pretty happy with it. So if I tap the shutter, just for a quick photo here, it's not that long, right? It's like, I can still get my subject pretty quickly. So I'm happy with the clarity. However, I did take a shot without this on, and with this on, I'll show you the difference. So I did take this comparison shot just to show you guys the difference, and it really does stand out. All I did was lift my phone up and quickly take a shot of this scene. And this is how it comes out of the box. And when you zoom in, you notice it's not exactly clear. The word propel isn't exactly crisp, and all of this isn't exactly perfect. And again, this is how it comes outside of the box. After this switch, bam. Prioritizing focus definitely makes it a lot crispier and definitely a better quality. So make sure to do that right away. All right, and now that we did that, there are some things you can kind of change here. So if you are a big fan of timer, you can do multi-shots, all that kind of stuff. I turn on audio monitoring because I do use external mics sometimes. So I'm gonna turn that on. And everything else, I have it how I have it here. So hopefully that will help you. All right, so now that we have that set up, let's go through some of these different features. So one, you can hold this to be able to quickly record a video, simple and easy. And when you do record it, you can actually move it up to lock it. So now it's stuck in regular video mode. This is really useful because it's a newer feature that wasn't a lot on before. So I do like the ability that you can do it now a lot more easily. And then you can still take a photo while doing this. So I love that. Perfect, simple and easy. Really love to have that just at your fingertips. And now we're gonna show the rest of the photo quality improvements and then go towards video. So first off, you do have a 12 megapixel standard. You do have 50 and 200. The thing to know about it, if you do need that much detail, fine, but you only really want it in daytime. In low light, 12 megapixels is going to be your best bet. So just go for that. For 50 and 200, progressively, you have to hold it more steady and have a lot more light. So just know that if you need a lot of detail, it's there, but most of the time you will not need it. I always do motion photos on, and that just allows you to make sure to have the ability to have a opportunity to take a shot that you may have missed. So when you didn't get the shot you exactly wanted, you can actually play it back and then see if you have it in there and then take another screenshot. I really like this because overall it just has a great ability to make me take better shots when I'm taking photos of either my son, who runs around a lot, or my dogs. And then we're gonna go into settings and change everything else from here. So first of all, I turn on suggest shots. It just kind of helps you line up a photo better. So that's one that I do recommend having on. Intelligent optimization. Now for those who just want a very minimum of AI optimization, you can actually do minimum if you really want that. I have enjoyed the maximum, so I'm gonna keep it there for now. And then you can also do scene optimizer. This is really good, especially when it comes to color. I've noticed this turned on makes it a lot better, so I would definitely keep it on so that it just looks better. Food look tastier, days look brighter, skies look darker. Exactly what you're looking for in a shot, it typically optimizes it. I like this very much. Now, when you swipe down at the shutter button, you can automatically go into burst shot or create a GIF, whichever one you want. I personally like to create a GIF, so I'm gonna leave it at that. For advanced camera options, I do recommend if you are a pro shooter, turn on RAW ability just so you can actually use RAW format for advanced photo takers. And then the first thing, we go to selfies. First of all, definitely save selfie as preview. Turn that off. This will make text legible and not reversed. A lot of smartphones don't always have this feature, and I really do always love this Samsung for doing that just because it's simple and easy to do. Switch up and down camera modes. One thing I love about Samsung is that it's really quick and easy just to switch between the selfie and non-selfie mode. Okay, now auto frames per second. I love shooting 60 frames, which we'll get to the video quality upgrade in a second, but definitely go this to 30 and 60 FPS. Video stabilization, you want that turned on. And under advanced video options, this is really, really important. So you always want to turn on the high bitrate quality video. This is actually going to improve your video quality. It's going to take up a bit more storage, but definitely a better quality. So I would really recommend this so much. Zoom in mic is really good for zooming in and taking better audio quality. However, 360 is okay. I personally don't always use it, but if you have specific headphones for it, like Samsung's, then feel free. All right, tracking autofocus, it's really good for kids and pets, but honestly, I don't like, because there is a better way to take better photos, and I'll go over that in a second. But you do have location tags, and that I always do turn on just to make it great and easy for that purpose. Shooting methods. You definitely always want to turn on voice commands. It's one of the best features to be able to do, just to be able to say smile, cheese, capture, shoot. It's really good just to be able to do that. When your hand is too far stretched out, it's perfect. It comes in handy so many times. Also, floating shutter. This is a really great feature just because you have a floating shutter button. So you don't have to tap the bottom over here. You don't have to press the volume rocker over here. It's something I wish every phone would have, because there's so many times when I just want to tap a focus and then take a photo, but it have to go all the way over here. But this one, you can move it wherever you want. And when you're done with it, just put it back with the other shutter. All right, there is also settings to keep. The main thing I always do is definitely keep the selfie angle, so that I always use the wider selfie. I never use the up close selfie. Don't see a need for it. So I just like it to memorize that. Everything else you can save if you want, but this is the main one that I always recommend saving. All right, now before I get to video and all the other modes, I do want to give a tip on how to take good photos and videos on all Samsung smartphones across the board. And that is, most Samsung smartphones let in a little bit too much light. It's a feature and a problem with all smartphones, to be quite honest. So Samsung just does a really good job of correcting it. And that is, instead of this shot, tap it, and this little sundial right here, you turn it down slightly. So if you tap it and then turn it down just a little bit, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna get a better shot than you would have gotten normal. So this is, you know, a good shot, but it's letting a little too much light in, and it doesn't give that nice depth and shadow, whereas this one does. It gives a more accurate depiction, exactly how these buttons and colors are, and that is what you're looking for. For most times, I would definitely take this shot instead of this shot, just because it's more true. And it's better when it's a brighter photo that you're seeing this difference, because over time, it typically always overexposes, and this is giving you better control. Do this with video too, it's a much better feature. All right, and speaking of video, now we're gonna get to it. So first and foremost, the absolute best resolution you can do here is going to be tapping this button right here, going to UHD, and going to 60. This is unbelievable quality. Every time I take a video like this, I have so many friends and family always tell me, wow, that looks absolutely stunning and amazing. It's better than 90% of other smartphones when doing this. It just really is so good. Definitely set it to this mode and you will be much happier. Now, I do want to also let you know about this steady shot right here. So this does lower the quality a little bit to QHD at 60, but this is like having a gimbal. So if you're moving around, if you're going crazy or anything like that, you're not going to see much of the shaking comparing to this one, where you're going to see a lot more shaking, a lot more things that go wrong. This one is going to be much better when it comes to that. So I would just recommend that, letting you know, this one is going to be really good. If you're active, you're moving a lot of active ways, this one you're going to want to turn on for that reason. Otherwise, keep it at the best quality. All right, and then we are going to go to more and show you a few other features that you really will like. So first of all, you can bring any of these down if you like. So one thing I like to do is take food shots. Samsung is probably the best for taking food shots. So if you are one of those people, I know I am, I would recommend doing that. Other thing I would recommend is having dual record down here, because it's really good. And lastly, for me specifically, I use Pro Video, and that's how I have my lineup down here. All these you can access anytime just by hitting more, but it's just one thing that I like to have here. So first thing is dual recording video. This is how you can actually be in your shot. So if you are a vlogger, if you are a person that likes to film yourself while taking video, you can do it. And you can even do it at UHD at 30 frames for both. You can also select the lenses here. So if you want to do the front and rear camera, so if you want to do the front and wide camera, these are the two that I would have right now. Or you can do, you know, having, oh, well, maybe I want to have it, so I have it here. You can really change this up as much as you want. So you can have the front camera and wide, which is the traditional way, but you can also film with wide and ultra wide just to get a better idea. So you can take, say, this one and then do this one. And now you're seeing two videos, one wide angle and one up close, but it's all in one video. So I love that aspect. And then you can even move this around. You can tap this to actually do it split screen wise if you want that better, or you can do a picture in picture, which is the traditional way. Also, in terms of how you download it, you can download it as two separate files or as one shared file. I like it as a saved video preview, but you can choose what you like. And then the last thing I want to go over is the portrait mode. I feel like a lot of people will use this, so I do want to go over this part before going into selfies. For portrait, I would turn down the blur strength. So this is something you can change after the fact too, but it's better if you change it in the middle. So I would say a light 3 is perfect. You don't want it to be too much because then it's just unrealistic, but you have it right at 3. That gives you that nice blur effect, and it really is good for that purpose. Now, portrait, I would only suggest using 2 when you're far away. When you're up close, the natural camera has a really good blur effect. So if I just have it right here, you can see the thing behind, everything behind it already gets blurry. So I don't need to do anything more than that. Like, you can have something in the background, and this is what's in focus. This is what looks good. Everything in the background is going to be blurred out naturally. So that is what I recommend doing instead of always using the portrait shot, unless you're further away. All right, now when we get into selfies, there's a couple of things. So first off, I always say, just go into the wider lens. This is actually being cropped in, so it zooms into it. So this is where I always keep it at, just simple and easy for yourself. But also with these layers, when you first launch it, you'll actually get color tone, whether it's natural or warm. I typically like warm. My wife likes natural more. I think it does depend on your skin tone, so just know that going in. But this is the two that you would get to choose from. Again, for me, it's warm, for you, it's natural, but see what skin tone is gonna work best for color tone section. Also under face, I would have everything off, but just so you know, if you want to get rid of wrinkles or acne or stubble, you can turn up smoothness. You have tone for more like definition. You have jawline to get a really strong jawline, and you have eyes to make your eyes even bigger. So if you had a late night, you can make your eyes bigger to stay awake. Now, the last thing we'll go into here is go when you go into video mode. Again, you can go FHD, go to UHD, 60, and that is the best quality. You'll thank me. Trust me, this is a much better video quality, and you have it in selfie, which Samsung is one of the few phones that does have this kind of quality up front. So I love them for that. All right, guys, hopefully you did like this video. Make sure to subscribe because I will go through all of the editing features, and there are so many cool editing features, from being able to remaster, to take away reflections, to take away shadows, all this kind of stuff in this section, and then all of the generative AI features that you can do in this section. There's so much to show you guys. Make sure to subscribe because that'll be its own separate video, but hopefully you did like this video. If you did, please give a like, thumbs up down below. Let me know what your favorite feature was in it as well. I'm curious to see what you guys like the most. Thank you as always so much for watching. This has been RICKY, the YouTube Tech Guy.
Thank you so much again for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Also, follow me on social media at YouTube Tech Guy. And check out some more great tech videos on your screen right now.